Network 125, the best way to watch TV on the internet worldwide.
Live webcast. TV on demand. Internet TV. Network 125.
Okay, we're back on Network 125 over 50. I'm Dick Wolfley. Right next to me is George McDermott. George is running for Congress in Maryland, the 4th Congressional District. And I want to do two things in this segment, George. I want to talk just for a minute about, we've seen people go to jail when they don't exactly go along with this little corrupt system. Elena Sassauer is one. Can you tell us that story in just
Elena, I've known Elena for 8 years now. She's a absolutely a most charming person I know. She is with the Center for Judicial Accountability out of White Plains, New York. Patriot number one. Her whole family is a family of patriots, dating back to the early 70s when her father, who was a judge, stood up against the corruption in the New York courts. They subsequently trashed him, and they trashed her mother. They have been fighting the fight to take back our courts from the gangsters. If you go to judgewatch.org.
Elena Sassauer, you can see that video, and you can see her being arrested and much, much more. You can get to know her on secretjustice.com. And Richard Fine, you can find out more about that and see that interview that was just done on fulldisclosure.net. The videos are all up there, and you can find out all about that. George, what can you do to fix this broken system? You know, how do you fight Congress?
Well, first you have to raise the awareness of the general public.
Right.
The average citizen in this country has no idea that they have almost no say in the voting of who gets elected and who does not.
Right.
And the Supreme Court, what little vote you had in 2008, you don't have any chance whatsoever of getting your candidate elected this year if he has any resistance to trying to straighten out this country, because the Supreme Court of the United States recently ruled that unlike me and you, we have one man, one vote. Mm-hmm. And that's what the Congress of the United States, that's what the Constitution says. Right. Well, the Chief Justice Roberts and the rest of those people up there who have lost contact in reality with the world now have decided that they'll negate all the one vote rules, people. Me and you, we have no
say.
What they've done is, he said in his most recent opinion, which I strenuously object on, and that's part of what I'm running on MarylandCorruption.com. You'll find the stories on Roberts and his court, and you'll find them on GeorgeMcDermott.com. I stand up and I go into the, I'm not afraid to walk in the halls of Congress and call the Tom DeLays and the Tom Arnolds and these other criminals what they are. I've asked for impeachment against them. I've filed official papers. I've filed complaints. You know, do you know that when Newt Gingrich left office, would you have ever voted, I don't know whether you're a Democrat or Republican, but he had over 800 complaints of misconduct, legal misconduct against him when he was running for office. And nobody hears that. Nobody hears that this man had these complaints of legal misconduct against him. And how he ever got to that office is unbelievable. And he now is trying to get back into the picture. But
you know, fine. One way I know that we can start to work on this is to vote for you.
Well, I would like everybody to know I am out here to run. I'll give you an analogy. The last campaign I ran, I financed all three campaigns myself with very limited dollars, and I got a what I thought was respectable. I mean, under $5,000, I ran a campaign for the United States Congress.
Right.
My competitors spent $2.5 million. Who got the votes? But it's not about that. It's about getting the word out in peace at the political debates and letting the media know where you stand and making, because every debate I videotape so that I can see where I was standing and where my opponents were standing. And we have to send a message. We need to clean out the House and Senate.
And they should all really just resign and go home.
Well,
truly.
A lot of them are.
With a few exceptions. You know, 8 years ago, if you would have said to me, who is Ron Paul? I would have said, I know who he is. He's a nut job.
No, he's not.
He's not a nut job. He's right.
He's not a nut job, but you've got to realize he's running as an independent.
Right.
All the money goes to the two major parties.
Of course.
And they spend all the money they can to discredit him.
Right.
You know, he has a good agenda. I think he would be wonderful for this country, but the powers that be are not going to let that happen. You know, just like myself, Donna Edwards right now, by the fact that I'm running, and I'm running as a legal reformist candidate, every lawyer in the Bar Association, every affiliated association will be piling money into her campaign. She's already spent $270,000 and hasn't even announced she's running yet.
Wow.
According to her website. So that brings up a big point.
And I wanna get people on board here, George. If you know, Obama, and I'm not saying anything good or bad about the man, of course if you've seen any of my other videos you'll know where I stand on that. But nothing good or bad about the man, but he raised a whole buttload of money by getting $5 at a time on the internet. So if somebody wants to give you $5 to help you out in the campaign, how can they do that?
Just send it, go to secretjustice.com, and my name and address is up there. I'll be honest, this year I haven't even set up a donation because I never asked for donations before. That was my duty to the country.
Right.
I totally agree with you,
and I totally understand it. But I want you to have every opportunity to beat
this
woman.
Now I would like to get funding to go in. I mean, it all starts with one. Any movement starts with one person. You get one person in there. We were hoping that Obama might be that.
But he wasn't. Obama
was a predetermined, the Bilderberger Group endorsed him over here in Fairfax, Virginia. And once they endorsed him, all the money goes to that group,
right?
The special interest group, you know, because he went from an unknown candidate with a pretty poor record as a senator, and he raised more money than any other candidate in history, raised and spent more money.
Mm-hmm.
Now, who's getting the rewards for that? The bankers are making absolutely. They're paying as much money as they can in his campaign to keep it going. I really thought that, I was really hopeful that he would make change because he talked it. He's a great orator. He's a great speaker.
Right. Absolutely.
And you know, this man he wooed a lot of people. You had Acorn behind him. Well, we found out about Acorn. I used to, you know. It's amazing. The Acorn threw all the support behind him, but as a former member of Acorn on their Maryland board, I never saw them actually help one member in the 4 years that I was there.
Right.
And I never physically saw one member come up and say, oh, I got my house refinanced, or you helped me. All they did was go around and round up people and take them to rallies. Okay.
We have to take another break. When we come back, I want to talk a little bit about, in our last segment, I want to talk about what can we do to fix this system. because it's obviously broke.
Oh, it's absolutely broke.
Absolutely broke.
It's beyond broke.
And we'll be right back.
Stop paying those high-priced cable and satellite bills. Watch all your favorite cable and satellite programs on the internet right now with the NETWOK125 TV and Video Guide. We'll show you thousands of channels and directories so you can watch TV on the internet right now. So go to tvandvideoguide.com to get started watching TV today.